Hello, hello, and welcome! Silrace here with a Hearthstone theme deck, and we are playing Thrall, because Thrall is the only way to bring certain creatures on board. This is the Molten Core Raid. Essentially, this features both some creatures you fight in Molten Core or fought back in the vanilla days, and these days still people visit Molten Core occasionally, and two dudes who used to venture there and all that stuff. So let's go through the card list here, just for the F of it. So firstly, Abusive Sergeant. Every guild had that abusive guy who's like, I am mean to all of you because you stood in the fire. You know the type, right? Then there is a Young Priestess, obviously. I mean, come on. Every raid guild had a priest of some sort in it when it came to Molten Core, because of, you know, shadow resistance buff. If nothing else, they could also heal, maybe. Depends on the player, huh? Flametongue Totem. This is here just for the fire effect, right? We are playing Shaman, so this is for that, or that thing. And just, you know, don't worry about it for anything else. It's just here for that. Loot Hoarder. Always the guy who wants every damn roll, who wants every freaking item, and, you know, every weapon is a hunter weapon. Anyway, Novice Engineer. Well, gnomes. Gnomes were all over the damn place in every alliance raid. You would find a gnome. And engineers, everyone liked engineering gadgets. And more gnomes. More gnomes, and this time in the form of a summoner, right? This helps get some of the dudes on play as well, but more gnomes. Lava Burst. What was Molten Core but lava, right? It was just lava and fire everywhere. Like, Lava Burst, it's the theme. Questing Adventurer. Well, we all played these, right, in World of Warcraft. Questing Adventurer. So, Molten Core, our goal. Kill them and get all the fat loot. Raid Leader. Well, this is the guy who led you all over the place, except this time he is just a buff bot. Right. Tauren Warrior, the tank. Every single raid needed a tank. In this case, we don't have a, well, you know, a good representation of the Alliance side tanks, but we have Tauren Warriors. Always better. Earth Elemental. Well, there was only one minion in the Molten Core, which was an Earth Elemental, that was Gar, and these dudes represent his little guys, right? It was a boss. Fire Elementals all over Molten Core, then, of course, Baron Geddon. Baron Geddon was evil. Everyone died to Baron Geddon at least a few times. Corehounds all over the place, because Corehounds were awesome. Ragnaros, the Fire Lord, the bad guy, big bad guy. And a couple Molten Giants, because Molten Giants were in Molten Core. Now, this took longer than my usual introduction, but I just wanted to, you know, reminiscence with Molten Core raids and all that stuff. Let's get to the gameplay, huh? Okay, first adventurer venturing into the Molten Core, a hunter. I have two Novice Engineers, I'm tempted to keep them, because the card draws are good. Usually I don't play theme decks with card draws in them, so this is a new experience. You know, my, well, theme decks are everything but card draw, because it doesn't usually fit into the theme I am playing. Anyways, let's see if this deck can actually win anything, because this is, let's just say this is not quite so hot of a deck. Oh cool, I get all my really early creatures. With the Loot Hoarder as well in play, that is nifty. Oh, Scavenging Hyena. Hey, well, that thing needs to die then, right away. Well, I'm actually okay with that. Should I play the Loot Hoarder or the Novice Engineer? I'll play the Loot Hoarder as the second guy, but this one gets to kill the Scavenging Hyena. And now he's like, what is this deck? What? Yeah, exactly. That's what this deck is, and that is an explosive trap. So that's fine, I get a card back from all this silliness. Hey, so that's nice and nifty. That is first explosive trap down as well. It's very, very nice. Novice Engineer for another card draw. Yep. And then drop down a totem, because, oh cool, we even get a clone totem. That is nice. Now I don't have a turn 5 play. Turn 6 play I have a really good one. Turn 7 plays are kinda lacking on this deck anyways. But, oh well, Animal Companion, let's see what you got, man. Ew, a hopper. Of all the damn things, you get a hopper. Ew. Do I draw anything which is a turn 5 play? No, I don't. So we will just drop this stuff up and head for the face here. Head for the face. Yes, I have finishers in hand. Double Lava Burst and a Ragnaros. But we are not here to play seriously anyways. We are just here to, well, play theme decks. And well, if we manage to get some kind of serious win all the way, that is nifty. Really? You arcane shot in my face? No, that's what I was already thinking. Like, what the hell? Arcane shot in my face? That would be interesting. But we can get rid of this guy in this turn, that is okay.
Sure.
Right, at least got some value out of the little dudes. Like, the 1-1 kills a fucking big thing, which is nice. So I have Molten Giant in hand, let's see, Hunter's Mark? Hunter's Mark, wait. Or do you have something other funkiness, like an explosive shot, because that would be nasty. Oh, 7 of high, man. Hey. Interesting. Yeah, Hunter's Mark. Alright. So he's wasting this on that. Yeah, right. That's nice. Point sized summoner. Well, if you wanna put down a big dog, I can put down a big dog. Like, well, okay. Dog eats the cat, right? Wanna put down a big cat? Well, I'll have a big dog. Okay. Yeah. Big cat, big dog. Whatever. Something along those lines. Turn 8 play, rag. This is just a YOLO rag, probably right away. Because he's low cool. There is the explosive shot finally. That also means the explosive shot does not hit rag. And since that is probably a freezing trap, it doesn't matter for rag. Raid Leader could work. Also, Molten Giant could really work, but he's probably gonna give me a free Molten Giant very soon here. So I guess we will drop Rag. Let's see what Rag has. Oh, Snipe! Cool! Didn't really expect Snipe at all, but well, that's okay. He can trade this guy for the Rag, that's fine. Then we can drop Baron Geddon and kill all the little guys. I am okay with that. Hellmaster, cool. And what the heck? Coin now what? Another explosive shot. Holy shit, this guy has explosive shots like all over the place. That is funky. Let's see. Oh, cool. Earth Elemental, thank you. What else do we wanna do here? He could Lava Burst down that guy. Yeah, that seems like a reasonable course of action. Because this should be a lot of his removal gone, so now he basically has to beat on my taunt. Let's see, Arcane shot my face? What will you have, Meister? Oh, kill command, finally. Finally! Cool. So, Tauren Warrior, and I can concede. Well played! Next game! Okay, second opponent is a druid. Flame Tongue Totem is kinda interesting. Problem is, it gets wrathed out of existence right away. So I guess I'll drop it for now. Let's see what else we get. Oh, Questing Adventurer. That's nice. I am okay with the Questing Adventurer. Oh, Tauren Warrior even. So turn 1, turn 2, turn 3, turn 4, this and a totem. Yeah, that seems reasonable. Seems very reasonable.
Someone called.
Okay, oh, Voodoo Doctor. Voodoo Doctor. Okay. So that makes Novice Engineer plays really bad, but that's okay, I guess. Because it's just hero power kill, hero power kill. All day long. I'm all. Eh well. Also, that thing kills Questing Adventurer. Which is a little bit annoying. So I guess we will have to Tauren Warrior it next turn. Instead of dropping Questing Adventurer. Eh well. That's fine. Wait, what? Deciding to hero power the 1-1 is too damn difficult. Oh well, I'm okay with that. Earth Elemental could be a really interesting turn 5 play, although it does overload me like mofo, but 7-8 on turn 5 is kind of funny. And then of course it gets killed by the nasty Black Knight, but that's fine. Wait, what? Okay, he lets me kill the 2-1? That is interesting. He chose to do it that way around. Now sure, he can clear the entire board here if he so desires. But that doesn't help overly much, I would say. I would dare say. Pint-sized Summoner is an interesting drop for next turn. Possibility. Possibly. So, eh well. Eh well, I might have to drop a Questing Adventurer next turn though, to try to get him on board, and then Abusive Sergeant it up. What? Eh well, we will see if he decides to be like intelligent and hero power into this and then attack it. Hey, Druid of the Claw. Yep. Where shall I strike? Druid of the Claw in comfort. And then don't attack? Okay, cool. So. Questing Adventurer.
Give me a quest.
You get to be on board now. Then we will drop this guy.
Get in there and fight, maggot!
Bob it! Into a 3-3! Oh, Shield Master. Curious stuff. He's playing really curious stuff. So now he attacks and kills this, and then he can kill the 2-1. Wait, what? Didn't attack? What in the blazes is going on? Okay, let us kill stuff then. Huh? Let us kill stuff then. Right?
Handle it.
Let us kill stuff. Because that kills that and stays alive. Right? And then we, yeah.
Quest accepted.
Then we smack down this thing here. Nice and nifty. Okay, that cleared the board kinda well. I mean, of course, this guy dies this turn. And then he has to, well, can wrath it for one for a card draw or whatever. And then this can still kill things. But hey, next turn it dies to the Fire Elemental anyways. What? Swipe! Cool! Right, so, you know, this thing still can do its business or whatnot. Wait, what? The blaze is going on here. Hey! Cool! Right, Fire Elemental kills that. I don't want it on board so it doesn't randomly get borrowed back to full health. And that is first swipe gone. And I killed a lot of little things. With a lot of little things. It is hilarious, in all honesty. Raid Leader is really nice when you get a big board of little dudes like that. I would have preferred if it was all totems, so I could throw out a whole bunch of totems on things. But I haven't had the mana and whatnot to just play a lot of totems here. Next turn I think it's gonna be Fire Elemental, yep, especially since he's burning more removal here. That's fine. Gonna be Fire Elemental then. No, not Fire Elemental. Earth Elemental, what am I talking about? Well, or it could be Baron Geddon. It will be Baron Geddon, since it just burned a star fire. It will be Baron Geddon. Bloody F, it will be Baron Geddon. Next turn we can drop an Earth Elemental to accompany Baron Geddon. Right. So what do you do now, Mister? could actually drop an earth element. Yeah, I could probably drop the earth elemental next turn to accompany. Oh, cool. A second starfire. Like, seriously? Well, that's both starfires gone. That means earth elemental is a very safe drop for next turn. And both starfires gone. Alright. So, we do that. And then we can drop Novice Engineer for a card draw. See what we get and drop another totem. Drop another totem. Barangeddon, huh? Barangeddon hasn't been doing so hot for this deck so far because it just gets owned every time. Yeah, well, Iron Bark Collector. That is funny. Right, do I get something nifty here? Oh, cool, I do. And we run this thing instead. Like so. And we drop and stop it here. Guess, yes, it got buffed. Awesome stuff. It got buffed. That is fantastic. Buffed the right damn thing. For once. Awesome stuff. Ancient of War with 10 attack? Wait, what? The heck? You're gonna attack into it and then... Okay, never mind. Don't attack into it. Although, I am tempted to clear the damn board here. I'm really tempted to clear the damn board here. I think we will do just that, my friend.
More training?
This... Come on, let me select it. This thing clears that, right? This thing clears that. And we plop down a totem. Yeah, we get a 1-1 totem, but this thing starts healing up again. That is fine. That is fantastic. Then there is obviously a swipe now, but... bloody F. I got rid of the big dudes. Iron Bark Protector, but not Iron Bark, but Ancient of War. With the 10-5. See, it is melting my brain already to see it played like that. It's very, very weird. Double Chillwind Yetis. That is funky. You have very interesting stuff here going on here, my friend. I'm not overloaded at all. That probably means Lava Burst next turn. Hello, Raid Leader. This could actually mean interesting business. Let's see what we draw first. Because I have the mana to draw stuff. Oh my word, a Flame Tongue Totem even. Oh my word. Flame Tongue Totem Raid Leader. And I can trade to my halves content here. Yeah. Flame Tongue Totem. Allows this thing to solo that, right? And Raid Leader buffs this to 4. So essentially all I have to do is Lava Burst this, right? Kill it. Drop another totem, because then this buffs it into an attacking totem. Let's kill that as well, and let's go to the face, and everything gets healed. Okay! That was funky. Let's see, what do you got? Dark Scale Healer. Alright. Ooh, man. So, I have a Raid Leader. No, you have to attack the taunt if you're gonna use an attack. With the Raid Leader, I could actually just straight up kill stuff here. Right? The Raid Leader, kill that. Right? Pop the new totem down and kill it.
Sure.
And just stop going for the damn face with all these things. And everything gets healed again. This thing used to be so nasty back in the day when healing totem actually healed the hero itself as well. It was with situations like this, the healing totem bigger game really, really overpowered. But, oh well, it already here shows its power. Okay, there is the swipe then. Mm-hmm. So now, there is one less threat on the board. And still, well, there, healing touch. Healing touch is nice for you. And then you can kill the Raid Leader. Which is nice as well. Whoa, killed the wrong target, man. Should have killed the Raid Leader. Really should have killed the raid leader here. Let us drop that there, and let us drop that there. And then we will go for this phase. More here. More to the face. This is got a bit drawn out game here, but that's fine. This is I am winning with a molten core raid. Oh, cute. An iron bark protector. Now kill the raid leader, man. Like, yes, finally. Correct target. Doesn't help you though. Does not help you though.
No play.
Well played.
No play. My time.
Does not help that they did that stuff. Oh well, that was a very fun game though. It ended up being a little one-sided at the end, which is a little annoying. But it was fun. Molten Core Raid triumphs.
Thrall.
Okay, next opponent here is a warlock. Novice Engineer and Questing Adventure, double fire elemental. Fire elementals are really good against warlock, but I don't want two of them, especially in the opening hand. Okay, this can work, I believe. So let's see, what do we get?
Greetings, friend.
What do we get here? Malloc Raider, alright. So, Novice Engineer it is. Tempted to coin it on turn 1, but we are not going to do that. We are not going to be that silly that we coin it on turn 1. Well, just gonna have to eat that 2 damage, that's fine. And wait, what? He did nothing on his 2 mana turn when he has a hero power like this? That is really funny. Oh well, I have a 1-1 on board now. Wolf Rider. Wolf Rider, alright. So, Right. Tauren Warrior. Kill that. Like so! OP and all that stuff, you know? Yes, I can use that to buff up my Tauren Warrior. Shadow Bolt, alright. So it ate a Shadow Bolt. And he does another little damage to my face, that's fine. Then I guess we since it just burns Shadow Bolt, do I do this? Do I just play this guy? With a coin? Yes, I do. Have fun with that! Since it just burns Shadow Bolt. Then this guy has to be the boy, right? Because this guy coming out on turn 4 is kinda nasty. But that means my turn 5 play is going to be utter garbage. Probably just drop a totem, hoping for a healing totem. Oh well, something like that. Something like that. You gonna run Bolt into it and then Shadow Bolt again? No. No Shadow Bolt, okay. That means we are seeing if we get a healing totem, that would be nifty, but we don't. And start dealing some damage back. So yeah. Okay, next turn at least we can play some stuff, which is nice. We can go questing adventurer with some other things. Okay, Reckless Rocketeer trades his life, right? Alright, that's good. Questing adventurer comes in an empty board then. That is actually really nice. So, questing adventurer and what? Let's actually drop the Tauren Warrior here. We have another taunt present. And we can drop a Flame Tongue Totem possibly next turn. And a regular. Yeah, definitely drop a Flame Tongue Totem now. Kill that thing. And kill Chilvin Yeti as well. Nice. Nice indeed. Abusive Sergeant. Oh my word, this is just getting better and better, huh? So, Flame Tongue Totem, right? Then we can even drop a pint sized if we want to. Or, do this. Do that, and, do I wanna lava burst this stuff up? Just for the, funsies, because that would allow me to clear the entire board, right? I mean, I can still clear the entire board, if I so desire. I think we might do just
quest
that,
accepted.
Huh? Abusive Sergeant allows us to get rid of this guy, and we get rid of that guy. And this pretty nice. Three, one, two, one, all that business, and I have second Flame Tongue in hand. I have Pint-Sized Summoner, which so far hasn't done overly much, but yeah, at least it's still sitting around, so I could drop it. But I don't have enough to follow up the Pint-Sized to really see a much of a point in dropping it at the moment. So that's a Shadow Bolt, huh? Yeah, what? Mortal Coil? Wait, what are you casting? Corruption? Who? Drain life, alright. So you kill that. And then I get another thing to do damage with. And I can actually play that thing. So I guess we are smack with this thing, huh? Then we drop a second Flame Tongue Totem here. Start doing damage. Right. Next turn is a win. So, yeah. Unless there is something funky like a Jaraxxus or whatever, next turn we win. Voodoo Doctor. Okay, that actually prevents the win unless I happen to roll a Spell Power Totem. I'm actually tempted to try that just for the heck of it. But yeah, this is still very much a one game here. Okay, so yeah, very much a one best game accepted. Here, and Flame Tongue Totem for the win. Next game! Okay, final game for the Molten Core Raid. To be it is a warrior. I'm tempted to keep the Flame Tongue Totem, but not the Abusive Sergeant. Let's drop it and let's see what we get instead. I would love to get those like 1-1s and 2-1s and all that stuff, because Warrior has a harsh time dealing with them. But at least I have two Flame Tongue Totems and an Earth Elemental. So that's something at least. Curious, because I have no plays for the next three turns other than just poking out the totem and more totems. Maybe a Flame Tongue. Ech, even get the rag, huh? Yeah, well, 1-1. 1-1 totem. That is actually a tempting target to drop a Flame Tongue for next turn, start... well, doing damage. Especially since there is nothing played on this turn other than just a armor up. Baron Geddon, yeah, Flame Tongue it is. Flame Tongue it is. Actually, I should play the Flame Tongue on the other side, come to think of it. But, oh well. I was hoping I would get a turn 4 play and drop something else on board and smack that dead. Fiery War Axe. No, a Whirlwind. Cool. So, this thing already ate the first Whirlwind. That is nice. That is really nice. So, give me a 2-drop, please. So I can play 2-drops and all that other stuff. So, basically that means there's one less Whirlwind to use to execute one of these big things which I'm about to drop. That is nice. It's quite nice. Don't really have... unless you wanna Inner Rage my stuff. Probably don't have much to play. Right? What are you dropping for a 1-drop? An Execute! Fantastic! That's a Whirlwind and an Execute gone. Oh my god, that is so awesome. Whirlwind and an Execute gun. That is so freaking fantastic. Cool. Even a 0-2, huh? Even a 0-2. That is fantastic. As in, the big 0-2 to pair with the Earth Elemental. Core Chronally. Okay, so do you kill the totem or do you go for my face? You go for my face. That is good. That is good. Please deal more damage in my face. Earth Elemental. Now, if Earth Elemental is the second execute, I am really, really thrilled by that concept. Because if it does, then yeah, that would be awesome for me, because I have all these other big things which want to eat the face, huh? So yeah, Baron Geddon should be funky enough. Actually, I would have loved to play Fire Elemental next turn, but obviously this guy overloads me like mofo, so I am not playing Fire Elemental next turn. I'm probably playing Young Priestess though, with a regular totem. But we will see. We will see. Indeed. A brawl! Come on, drop the brawl! Oh, cool. Plus 2 attack, huh? Plus 2 attack, huh? Okay, that means you can kill it the following turn, which is nice. For you. Whoa, he did not attack. That is very crazy, my friend. That is very crazy indeed. Okay, the second taunt. Start dealing damage to your face. Get a second taunt. That is actually kinda nice. Get a second taunt. Then you can Fire Elemental next turn. Or Baron Geddon, whichever I feel like doing. Guess Baron Geddon is fun. I'm pretty crazy. Hellwreck. Charge! Okay. Plus 2 attack and charge. So then he kills the totem with it. Kills the totem with it. Kill the totem with it. Wait, what? What the hell? Inner range? What? Gonna inner rage that to hopefully get, but it still doesn't do 8 damage if you inner rage it. Wait, what? Okay. This just looks so silly, hey. Do something.
I must choose.
Do stuff. Very indecisive person, I guess. Like, your turn is almost over. Do something with this charge and 5 attack. Like, at least kill the taunt totem. Kill the taunt totem. What? Okay. That was very weird. That was very weird, indeed. Let us drop ourselves a fire elemental. Because, what? Very, very weird combination of things. It should have like attacked and killed this. It had a charge, right? It's like, at least use it for something, right? If you give it charge. Anyways, I do realize the rankings I'm playing at, but please read what the cards do when you play this game. Because that will help you immensely. Like, it wasn't such a bad play to give it charge, because he could have cleared both of my taunts at least out of the way and still have a 5-3 with a charge on board, but didn't use the charge for any effect, and now it is a dead bear. It got burned to a crisp bear flanks. Anyway, let's see what you come up with next turn. Bully Bear Bodyguard. Okay. Cleave! Let's see, what do you have? Cool! Both things which actually live! That is so perfect! Oh my gosh! Oh, now I'm tempted to drop Raid Leader with an Abusive Sergeant, just kill the freaking 5-4. Actually, this would do it just for with the two totems alone. But I think we will YOLO RAG! Just because, no. We won't YOLO RAG, we will just get rid of this guy, right? Because screw him, huh? Raid Leader. And a totem. Get rid of that guy. Like so! See what else happens here. Oh, cool! The totem got more health. Fantastic. Shield block. YOLO RAG next turn. Do you know obviously what else is on the board, but that seems the course of action. Probably at this point I should probably drop Baron Geddon just to, you know, make this fair at some point. Or some description of a like fair game. Oh well, that's fine I guess. This is very interesting because you lose now. Well played. Well played. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you folks another time with more Hearthstone and more other videos I do. Like I said, thank you very, very much for watching. Molten Core wins!